to an absolutely beautiful Halloween day here in Tuscaloosa as the Crimson Tide gets set to play host to the Southern Miss Golden Eagles. Bama coming in at 4-3. Southern Miss also enters the game at 4-3. We welcome you to Bryant-Denny Stadium, everyone. David Crane joined with Chris Stewart. Alabama and Southern Miss renewing an old border war. Always a tough game, Chris, when these two teams get together, but a very special day for the Bama senior.
It is indeed. Anytime they get a chance to play in Tuscaloosa, it's a lot of fun, but this is their final time to play at this stadium. So many memories running through their minds. They want to leave this game with some great memories as well.
Mike Dubose and his club trying to bounce back from the loss at Tennessee a week ago. Coach Dubose talking about his defense and needing more productivity this week.
They were in position last week. They have been the last 2 and 3 weeks. They're just not wrapping up making tackles. He talks all the time about players making plays. He needs his defensive players to do that this week.
Offensively, of course, Sean Alexander is going to be there for the Tide. You hope he has a big day, but Bama's starting to look to some of the youth, and there's a lot of it on this team.
When you've got talent such as number 2, Eric Locke, and also number 15, Freddie Millins. Just 6 catches on the year, but he has 5 of them in the last 2 games. Great speed. He could be a real key in this game for Alabama today offensively.
Another important part of the Alabama offense, at least the Tide coaches are hoping it can be a part, is the place kicking game and Ryan Pflugner. He has struggled as of late. He's got a strong leg. He just needs to make some.
They tried to open up the kicking job this week and found out there was no battle for this job. He's the top kicker in camp. They just need this young man to execute. Plenty of leg strength. He just needs to start making the kicks.
The Alabama offense has looked good at times this year, especially against BYU and Vanderbilt, but the Tide has sputtered as of late, finding the end zone. Alabama's going to look to its future to hopefully find the end zone
since
from here on out.
Since 70 points in its first 2 games, the Crimson Tide has managed just 77 in its last 5. The offense has moved the ball well at times, but finishing a drive has been the exception rather than the rule.
We're moving the ball and We can't convert a field goal, or we can't even punch it in the end zone. That's getting frustrating because, as Coach said, you don't get points for yardage. You don't get points for the end zone.
You've got to continue to move the football, and we've made some improvements here making first downs. But when we get the ball down in the red zone, we've got to score points. We've got to score touchdowns. If we don't score touchdowns, then we've got to kick the field goal. We've got to make it.
We need to finish. I mean, it's just another thing, that, you know, getting close and finishing. It's just something that we've struggled with basically the whole year. And I would think at the end of the year, maybe we should go ahead and kind of finish off some of our drives, but I guess it comes with practice.
Recently, Bama has been looking more to its future, namely Eric Locke and Freddie Millins. The true freshmen have been featured more prominently in the game plan, and the coaches know they need to touch the ball more often.
Well, they're athletic guys, and they are guys that we have to get more and more involved in our offense, and they are guys that are starting to emerge as some playmaking.
And they really compliment the other guys. They're real humble guys, you know what I mean? They just do whatever's asked, but I expect them to, you know, grow the rest of the year and then, of course, have a great spring, but they're legit players.
You know, everyone has to sit back and remember that it's a team effort, and it's a matter of being patient, that everyone will have their chance, and you just have to be patient.
With Sean Alexander, Andrew Zow, Tyler Watts, and a lot of the other weapons returning next year, the future is bright for the Bama offense. But at 4-3, the Tide knows the future needs to begin this Saturday.
We're still planning to win out, you know. We want to win every game. We want to play our hardest and show everybody that we really are a good Division I team. Get better each and every game.
All we got to do is just don't overlook nobody. Especially Southern Miss, because it's a team people just tend to overlook. They play Alabama good every year. Take it as a challenge.
Team captains from the 1973 championship team delivering the game ball. Wilbur Jackson, Chuck Strickland on hand today, commemorating the 25th anniversary of one of the best teams in Bama history. 1973 team losing to Notre Dame and a heartbreaker in the Sugar Bowl. Chris Stewart, another sold-out crowd on hand. Something very special for the folks who have not been to a Bama game this season. The Jumbotron, part of the atmosphere here in Tuscaloosa for bringing the team onto the field.
Thank you.
not a bad entrance, Chris Stewart. The Tide and about 84,000 fans here at Bryant-Denny Stadium getting set to take on the Southern Miss Golden Eagles. Bama trying to bounce back, as we mentioned in the pregame, from the tough loss to Tennessee a week ago. The Tide was in it for a long time, but just could not pull it out.
When Sean Alexander burst through the Tennessee line and pulled the Tide to within 3 points, the entire stadium went silent, except for those parts that were wearing crimson. It seemed as though the momentum had shifted completely in the Crimson Tide's favor, but just like that, Fearless Price breaks one 100 yards on the ensuing kickoff, and things had shifted back in favor of the Volunteers. A new week, though, and Alabama has a very formidable foe on their hands today.
Southern Miss coming in at 4-3 in an outstanding club, the Golden Eagles, a very balanced offense with a lot of Alabama guys on that roster.
25 on roster, about 20 expected to play, but maybe none more important than that young man, a true freshman, Derek Nix from Atala, Alabama, played at Etowah High School, was a recruited as a linebacker as well as a running back, but his brother is a coach at Southern Mississippi, elected to go the route of the Golden Eagles. And that young man, Adalius Thomas from Equality, Alabama, out of Coosa Central. He is the all-time sack leader at Southern Mississippi. He has 8.5 sacks per game, or for the season, I should say, coming into today.
We mentioned that the Crimson Tide is about a 3-point underdog playing at home to Southern Miss, and keys today, Chris Stewart, for both teams.
For Southern Miss, they need to continue the success they've had in the running game. Three straight games, Derek Nix has rushed for over 100 yards, and defensively, they want to be in the face of Alabama's redshirt freshman quarterback, Andrew Zow. They come with a lot of different looks to the Golden Eagles. They want to cause him problems today. For Alabama, they need to correct the mistakes they made a week ago in special teams, more solid play there. And defensively, we mentioned it earlier, don't just be in position defensively, make plays, wrap up, make tackles, and don't let Southern Miss gain any confidence in this game.
Jeff Bauer, head coach for the Golden Eagles, in his eighth year in Hattiesburg, 49-38-1 overall. He has done a great job. He is 0-for against the Crimson Tide, though, as a Golden Eagle player coach. Mike Dubose, in his second season at the helm of the Crimson Tide program, 8-10 overall, 1-0 against Southern Miss, the Tide winning 27-14 a year ago in Birmingham.
And as an assistant coach, 1-0 against Alabama. When he was at Southern Mississippi, they beat the Crimson Tide here as well.
Brandon Francis is the deep man for Southern Miss. Bama won the toss and deferred to the second half, so the Golden Eagles will take the ball. Mark Wisniewski will kick away for Alabama. And for the final time in Tuscaloosa this season, we are underway. Francis takes it at the one. Out across the 20 where Chris Horn brings him down. Return of 20 yards for the Golden Eagles. As we said, an absolutely gorgeous day here in Tuscaloosa, low 80s, hard to believe it's Halloween. And the turf has held up very well this season. They had some problems with it early on, preseason actually, but so far so good. It's done an admirable job withstanding the punishment. Lee Roberts, the starting quarterback for Southern Miss, second only really to Brett Favre in Golden Eagle history. Nix, the ball carrier, straight ahead. Up near the 30 where Tony Dixon brings him down. A pickup of 9 on first down. A look at the Southern Miss offense. Derek Nix, Sherrod Gideon, Todd Pinkston, Eddie Shaw, Antonio Franklin. Skill positions across the front of Lester Pope, Blackman, Firestone, Hopgood, and McClendon. Roberts, the senior from Pace, Florida. On second down, Cornelius Griffin on the spot for the Tide. Drives Nix backward. He may have lost about a yard on the play. Defensively for the Tide, Grimes, Cornelius Griffin, Kenny Smith, Kendall Moorhead across the front for Bama. Trevis Smith, Travis Carroll, Canary Knight, the linebackers. We'll get to the secondary with a substitution in the starting lineup in just a moment. Loss on the play. Third down and about 3 for the Golden Eagles. Nix one more time straight ahead. He will have the first down across the 35. Travis Smith makes the tackle for the Tide. In the secondary for Alabama, Bailey Dixon and Spencer are there. Fernando Bryant, who has been banged up all week, did not start. Reggie Miles actually started for the Tide, but Fernando in the game now on first and 10 for Southern Miss at their own 36. Roberts to the air for the first time today, and it's intercepted. Reggie Miles picks it off at the Bama 42. He was looking for Sherrod Gideon, but great coverage by the freshman from Pascagoula, Mississippi.
Right on cue. Let's take a look at Reggie Miles in single coverage across the way. Roberts had time to throw, trying to go to Sherrod Gideon, and a huge play right off the bat for the Alabama defense. Four times last year, the Golden Eagles turned it over against the Crimson Tide, and that is not a good start for USM offensively.
So Bama gets the turnover. The Tide sets up shop at its own 42. Andrew Zow will throw on a first down. High, intended for Eric Locke, incomplete.
Well, he had to throw it quickly. John Nix from Loosedale, Mississippi, was right in Andrew Zow's face, and he had to dump it real quickly. The young man showed a lot of courage last week. The numbers may not be overly impressive, but anybody that saw the licking he took against Tennessee last week had to walk away with a great deal of respect for the true freshman from Lake Butler, Florida. Hit time after time, but continued to pop right back up and gave Alabama a chance to win that ball game.
Second down, Bama shows the option. The pitch back to Alexander. Over the right side, he takes it into Southern Miss territory. Brought down at the Golden Eagle 45-yard line. A pickup of 13 for Sean Alexander. Adelius Thomas finally brought it down after he picked up the Bama first.
Well, this is obviously a great pickup for Alabama, but not a good trend for the Tide. Twice in successive plays, Andrew Zow has been leveled.
Alexander and McClintock will be in the backfield for the most part. Across the front, those five men have played a lot of snaps this season for the Crimson Tide. On first down, Bama with two fullbacks in front of Sean Alexander, who gets the carry, working his way through traffic. Rumbles forward to about the 40, where he's finally brought down by a host of Golden Eagles.
They disguised it a little bit that time, David, but that was the power look from Alabama with both Dustin McClintock and Montoya Madden in the game. Alabama had good success against Tennessee last week with those two guys running interference for Alexander.
Defensively for Southern Miss, Cedric Scott, DeQuincy Scott, John Nix, and Adelius Thomas. Across the front, Trey Ann Slaughter and Bell, the linebackers, Mallard Parrish, Watts, and Gonzalez in the secondary. Second and five, Zion on the rollout, completes it to Quincy Jackson, helping up for the first down. Deshaun Mallard pushes him out, but it's a gain of seven and another tied first down.
Alabama doing a nice job on the right side blocking John Nix, the defensive end on that side, never a factor in the plays. You saw both Alexander and McClintock creating a bit of a wall for Zow until he could find Jackson. And Bama moving the chains nicely here on their opening series.
Zow splits wide. Eric Locke works from the shotgun. Locke inside the 20. And Darius Thomas finally brought it down. Coach Mike Lewis trying to spice things up a little bit on offense. We thought we might see that. Just not so sure it'd be this early in the game.
How fitting on Halloween that Eric Locke would come dressed as David Palmer. Takes the direct snap, got some running room, and you see his quickness. They've worked on that all week, and there's some other wrinkles involving that young man that we can look for throughout the day.
Gain of 16, another first down for Alabama at the Southern 16. Play action for Zow into the end zone. Complete just off the hands of the diving Shamari Buchanan.
That's a shame because Griff Redmill, the right guard for Alabama, did a great job of keeping Adelius Thomas off of Andrew Zow until he could find Buchanan open in the end zone. veteran receiver was open, had his hands on it, just couldn't bring it in. Back to the power look, David, with McClintock and Madden in there again.
Sean Alexander, the running back for the Tide. On the handoff, Alexander dancing through traffic. Takes it down to near the 13-yard line. T.J. Slaughter on the stop. A Birmingham native out of John Carroll High School.
Outstanding player at John Carroll, where he played for Mark Frank, 6'1", 234, and a junior. By far the leading tackler on this Southern Miss football team with 96. He also has three sacks and a couple of passing breakups. Had a miss last year, a medical redshirt year because he had two badly sprained ankles, did not play at all.
Third down and six for Alabama. Eighth play of the drive coming up. Zow works from the shotgun into the end zone and overthrown, looking for Michael Vaughn.
Good coverage from Leo Barnes there as they try to go on the fade to Vaughn, and that obviously makes the dropped pass by Buchanan that much worse for the Crimson Tide as Flugner gets his first try today.
It'll be a 30-yard attempt for Ryan Flugner. He is 7 out of 15 this season, along a 55 against Arkansas. As we said, leg strength is not his problem. Accuracy from long range especially. Well within his range, and it's good.
What a confidence boost for that young man. It immediately goes to his snapper, Bradley Ledbetter, and the guys up front that gave him plenty of time to get that kick off. Good to see him start off well and execute some points for the Tide when they get the opportunity.
Right down the middle for Ryan Flugner. So the Crimson Tide takes advantage of the turnover by Southern Miss and turns it in to an early field goal and the 3-0 lead.
Alabama's been very impressive in the red zone this year. 10 of 12 coming into the game. Just over 83% of the time they have scored. 7 touchdowns, all of them rushing, by the way. And now 4 field goals by the Crimson Tide. When they get inside the red zone, they just need to get inside that 20 more often, because obviously they can execute when they're there.
But once again, as we mentioned in the pregame, the offense moving the ball well, coming away with points, but touchdowns still eluding them.
I don't know that Alabama's had a better opening series, a more impressive opening series all season long. The only problem, the obvious thing, the dropped touchdown pass by Buchanan.
Wisniewski will kick off again for the Tide. Brandon Francis, the deep man for Southern Miss. Low line drive kick that will go through the end zone, just barely able to keep it just inside the pylon, so it'll be a touchback, and Southern Miss takes over at its own 20.
As we mentioned a little bit earlier, tough game for Lee Roberts last year against Alabama. He was 21 of 40, 2 interceptions, did throw for 226 yards and a touchdown. Southern Miss had turned momentum in their favor a year ago before Kenny Smith made a big play playing against one of his home state teams. Hopefully Kenny can have another big game today.
On first down, Nix gets the call, and he's met in the backfield by Travis Smith and others.
We talk about the number of Alabama kids on the Southern Miss roster. There are obviously a lot of Alabama players from the state of Mississippi as well, and I gotta tell you, when they pick up a newspaper and see Southern Miss being a 3-point favorite in their own house, that has got to serve as a little extra momentum, a little more motivation.
Loss of one on the play brings up second and 11. Roberts running the option, met at the line by Cornelius Griffin. May have gotten the yard back, lost on first down, but it will bring up third and long.
I don't think you'll see that play too often today from Southern Miss. Lee Roberts with 22 carries now on the year, but he's only gained 16 yards. He's lost 103. Not the best of percentages there. Minus 87 coming into the contest. Obviously, a lot of those are sacks that are figured into the numbers.
Third down and 10 officially for the Golden Eagles. Roberts checking off at the line. Brandon Francis in the backfield with him. Roberts chased down, swings it out to Francis, and he's met behind the line by Tony Dixon. Tried to set up the screen perhaps, but there was nobody out there helping Brandon Francis. Travis Carroll almost brought him down for the sack.
Good to see number 44 stepping up early. And while he won't figure into the play statistically, watch him force Lee Roberts to scramble and then dump this thing off. Mike DeBose challenged Travis this week. He said, I've either have to lower my expectations of you, or you have to raise your expectations of yourself. Travis Carroll said, don't stop thinking that I can be an All-American. Travis trying to step his game up.
Jamie Purser punts it away for Ole Miss. 38 yards on the kick. No return by Arvin Richard. And for the second time today, Alabama will set up shop at its own 42. Another look at the punt by Jamie Purser. Bama with some good pressure. And then some.
A little contact. Not a bad acting job either on the part of Purser.
Referee Steve Landis back there said no harm, no foul. Zow on first down, plenty of time. Completes it to Arvin Richard out of the backfield. Leo Barnes on the tackle. He takes it into Southern territory and will have a first down for the Tide at the Golden Eagle 45.
You know, we've seen Andrew Zow enough now that I shouldn't be surprised, but just great arm strength. You see, he just flipped the football there at the last minute. It wasn't even a true delivery. Just snapped it off a nice little 15-yard pass or so with a wrist, and his confidence is gaining week by week.
Vaughn, the man in motion for the Tide. Zow to throw again. Flushed out. And now runs out of bounds. Steps out back at the 42, so a big loss on the play. Cedric Scott finally forced him out of bounds, waited a hair too long to get rid of it, and he takes the big loss.
Well, he wanted to go deep to Michael Vaughn, but he was covered well by Terrence Parrish, number 24. Then you see the underneath man, Quincy Jackson, was his outlet receiver, but he was well covered also, and nothing for Zow to do but eat the football.
A loss of 13 on the play. So it'll bring up second down and 23. That's the type mistake that has been a drive killer for Alabama, be it a penalty or a miscue. And now the Tide facing second and long, sets up the screen to Sean Alexander. With some blocking in front, Alexander still on his feet. Takes it back down to the Golden Eagle 46 before Leo Barnes brings him down. So it's been feast or famine, a pickup of 13, a loss of 13, and a pickup of almost 13 again that time by Sean Alexander.
We had four guys out there, but still Southern Miss was able to weave through and finally make the stop of Sean Alexander, but not until he gets back to the original line of scrimmage. Sean used more and more as a receiver the last few weeks.
Brings up third down and officially 11 yards for the Crimson Tide. Pressure coming from Southern. Incomplete, intended for Eric Watt, perhaps just a little bit behind him.
A little behind him, and I don't think he saw the football until the last minute. He turned very quickly, and I just don't think he saw the football until too late.
Golden Eagles came with some pressure. Perhaps Zow had to hurry it just a little bit. Regardless, fourth down and 11, Daniel Pope, the SEC's leading punter, into the game for the Tide. There you see his numbers on the season, averaging 43.7 a kick. Great year for him. One of the co-captains for the Tide. Hangs it up high. Chad McGeehee down there, and he'll touch it dead at about the 1.5. A 45-yard kick. Good coverage on the Bama special teams, and the Tide's got Southern backed up deep.
Among the nine kickers, you'd have to say Chad McGee. He has been the most consistent special teams player. And just look at him. Set up around the goal line and wait for the football to come to him. What a solid player he has been in the kicking game this year for the Tide.
We call his name several times every week on special teams. And a nice job of Daniel Pope hanging that one up, letting the coverage get down there. And now the Golden Eagles backed up officially to their own two. Not much there. Kenny Smith meets Nix right as he got to the line of scrimmage. Little or no gain. He may have lost about a half yard on the play. And
not much more room to lose if you're Southern Miss. Travis Smith also stepping in, putting a hat on him.
Nix, the running back, stands about 5 yards deep in the end zone. They get to Nix in trouble. Kenny Smith got penetration. Nix.
We showed great balance
in the backfield, but able to dive out of the end zone and avoid the safety.
Exactly right, because they knocked him down, but he was able to put a hand down, keep his legs going, and just get beyond the goal line. Big hit again. Kenny Smith trying to grab him low as well, just spun off and somehow picked up a half yard.
They mark him at the one. Third and 11. Bama crowd trying to make it tough on the Golden Eagle offense. Roberts will throw from the end zone and complete. Todd Pinkston makes the catch for Southern Miss at the 19. That'll be good for the first down. Gutsy call by Jeff Bauer, but it picks up 18 and a first down.
Bama came with a blitz. Travis Smith trying to get through there, but a good little jump pass from Roberts. And you see Marcus Spencer trying to make the play. He has had to move into a starting role since Kelvin Sigler was lost. Tony Dixon moving over to the safety spot, and it moved Spencer into a starting role, and he has got to step up.
Roberts down the boundary and caught. Sherrod Gideon will take it the distance for the touchdown. 81 yards, and the Golden Eagles take the lead.
A lot of people forgot about Southern Miss when they started the season off with big losses against Penn State and Texas A&M. Didn't give them much credit against Southwestern Louisiana. They're 1-3 to start the year, but when you've got players like Sherrod Gideon, you're a dangerous offensive team. They've got Derek Nix to provide a compliment in the ground game, and this is an outstanding Southern Mississippi football team. We see the quick strike again.
Tim Hardaway tacks on the extra point, so Bama and Southern backed up deep, but the Golden Eagles get out of trouble and take the lead on the 81-yard touchdown pass from Lee Roberts to Sherrod Gideon.
We saw the matchup earlier won by Reggie Miles as he made the pick, but here they're just able to burn him right on the money. Roberts hitting Gideon in stride. He's got tremendous speed. Nothing that Tony Dixon could do but watch him head to the end zone. Now let's see how the Alabama offense responds. They moved it very well on their opening series before being limited to a field goal and then had to punt on series number two. From a momentum standpoint, you need the Tide offense to move the football. If not pick up points, then certainly change field position back in favor of the Tide. But as we just saw, I don't know that field position really matters to Southern Miss.
Gideon picking up his 10th touchdown catch of the season. Jeff Bauer breathing a little easier now, leading 7-3. Four plays for Southern, all it took to cover 98 yards, a minute 57 off the clock, and again the 81-yard touchdown pass to Sherrod Gideon, the leading receiver on what is really an explosive Southern Miss offensive football team. They've scored 56, 37, and 41 in their last three outings. Against Louisville, Army, and East Carolina. Brant Hanna set to kick it away for Southern. Pritchard and Freddie Millins, the deep men for the tie. Hannah drives this one out of the end zone. And Bama will take over at the 20. 4:44 to play here in the first quarter, and Southern leads it 7-3.
Lee Roberts, Southern Miss quarterback, just adding to his numbers with that 80-yard or 81-yard touchdown throw. He's only the second Southern Miss quarterback in history to throw for more than 2,000 yards in a season, threw for just over 2,200 last year. Of course, as you mentioned, Brett Favre, the only other quarterback to do so in USM history.
Alexander, the ball carrier, leapfrogs a man, takes it out to the 25. T.J. Slaughter on the stop. But another good pickup for Bama on first down.
Get it out beyond the 25. Bring Montoya Madden back into the game. He, along with Dustin McClintock, the power look, if you will, for Alabama, along with the tight end Terry Jones.
Second and five for the Tide. Alexander stacked up in the backfield. Cedric Scott met him not long after he took the handoff from Andrew Zow. Thomas in there as well.
Darius Thomas, just 49 tackles, third best on the team. But of those 49, 15 have been for loss. Total of 88 yards in losses coming in. He is a tremendous player on that defensive front for Southern Miss. And again, another Alabama kid who will step up his game against the home state school.
Third down and six, the Tide 0-for-2 so far today on third down. Pressure coming for Zow over the middle. Caught, Freddie Millins out across the 40-yard line. That's good for the first down. Gonzalez and Barnes combine on the hit. But one of those speedy freshmen we talked about in the open.
Well, you're right. And only six catches, as we said, coming into the game, but five of them have come in the last three contests. And you see why. Good speed, more confidence as a receiver. And if not for the double team, we may have seen a little more of that speed from Freddie Millins in the open field. Good throw, though, from Zow.
Pretty good hands. That was a bullet from Andrew Zow. First down for the Tide. Andrew Zow off to a pretty good start. 4 out of 8 for 50 yards. They go back to the running game on first down. Alexander picks up a couple before he's brought down by Ty Trahan and Jose Gonzalez.
Shifted McClintock and Montoya Madden to the left side, and really using McClintock in that H-back role, which is, depending on really where he lines up, either a fullback, tight end. Very versatile player is Big Red, and he's back in that H-back look again.
From the shotgun, the give to Alexander, straight ahead. Up near the 45, pickup of about 3 on the play. Adalius Thomas there to make the tackle again. Big offensive line for Southern Miss on the sidelines. They'll mark it at the 44. Officially 3rd and 6 for the Tide. Zow going from the shotgun. Pressure coming. Screen over the middle to Millins. With blockers, Millins takes it into Golden Eagle territory. Brought down at about the 46 by Larry Watts. But you get the feeling every time number 15 touches the ball, he's about a step away from taking it the distance.
How did he know we were going to talk about him in the pregame?
We appreciate it.
We very much do. The big hogs getting out there, creating a little running room for Freddie.
First down for Bama. Sean Alexander reverses direction, finds a hole. Alexander takes it outside as a flag comes in. Alexander still on his feet. He will take it into the end zone for the touchdown, but let's check the flag. It came in awfully late and really from a bad spot on the field.
And that's going to wipe away one of the more impressive runs that Sean Alexander's ever had at Alabama, and he has had quite a few.
an illegal block called against the Tide. And a lot of work for nothing for that man.
Looked like he was going to be down at the line of scrimmage.
The run, illegal block in the back by the offense, 10-yard penalty, repeat first down.
See if we can pick it up on the replay. Mike Dubose getting an explanation and begrudgingly accepts it.
Take a look at the right side of our screen. May have been one of the receivers. It was Michael Vaughn, and that's very unfortunate because that's one of your upperclassmen making a mistake that cost Alabama a touchdown.
Kelly takes it back to the Southern 45, where it's officially first and 13 after the penalty. Arvin Richard, the ball carrier that time for Bama.
Arvin Richard, the ball carrier.
Pulls his way forward near the Golden Eagle 40.
Dave, we talk about how Eric Locke and Freddie Millins have worked their way into more playing time. Arvin Richard's really done the same thing. And in the early part of the season, he came into the game to spell Sean Alexander, but really used more as a decoy. Not anymore. He's an offensive threat as well with the ball in his hands.
Had 157 all-purpose yards last week against Tennessee. Toss sweep to Richard this time, trying to turn the corner. Forced out around the 39 by Terrence Parrish. So a short game on second down for the Tide and Arvin Richard. 5'7" sophomore from Atlanta, Georgia, former walk-on. The Bama program, Coach Mike Dubose awarding him a scholarship just before this season started.
One of my favorite players to interview because he's one of the few I can look down at.
You and me both.
That's the truth.
3rd and 7. Bama's 2 out of 4 so far today, and could be the final play of the first quarter. Zow to throw. Completes it. Near the 30-yard line. The diving catch by Tim Bowens. And that's good for the first down.
Take a look at the replay. You're going to see Eric Locke create some room for Tim Bowens, who does a nice job of getting beyond the marker. There you see Locke number 2 forcing the attention to the inside, and Bowens going down, making the catch. Made sure, though, he got to the first down mark before going down.
We're picking up 7 in the first quarter. Sack across the middle. Locke goes up to get it. There he was. Makes the tackle. But Locke, another of those outstanding true freshmen, picks up another first down for the Tide.
Alabama. Talked about Eric Locke creating a little running room, or a little room for Tim Bowens on the previous play. You saw Jackson going deep, open it up underneath.
First down, Bama at the 17. Eric Locke works from the shotgun again. Flag comes in late. Locke reverses his field and is dropped back at the 25-yard line. So Southern ready that time for the late shift on offense. Check the flag. Looks like it may be against the Tide.
It's not a happy man right there, Mike Dubose. Second time we've seen the snap to Eric Locke. Tries to
illegal
create
formation,
something.
Only 6 men on the line on the offense. Penalty refused, second down.
It was T.J. Slaughter who was chasing him throughout, number 34. Mentioned him a little bit earlier. Outstanding player out of John Carroll High School in Birmingham.
Golden Eagles will decline the penalty because it's a loss of 8 on the play, bringing up second down and 18. McClintock, the H-back, but Bama going with 5 wide receivers. Zow brought down by Adarius Thomas, who came in untouched to the Bama backfield.
Matt's not happy. We're going to see why here. Nobody getting in the way of Adarius Thomas. He's tough enough to keep out of the backfield when you've got someone blocking him. But they come with a blitz up the middle. Alabama with no chance.
So the Tide had another good drive going, has put it in reverse on offense. It's now third and 26. Again, the five wide receiver set for Bama. Zow steps up. Goes deep. Open. Vaughn. Touchdown. I don't know how he got that wide open. But Michael Vaughn was doing jumping jacks in the back of the end zone trying to get Andrew Zow's attention.
Well, I can tell you how he got open. Deshaun Mallard and Leo Barnes both came up to try and guard Quincy Jackson, who was standing around the five-yard line. And Michael Vaughn was all alone trying to hide himself in the back of the end zone.
Ryan Fliegner, a perfect 16 of 16 on extra points this year. And he's now 17 for 17 as the Crimson Tide jumps back on top. Compliments of this 33-yard touchdown strike from Andrew Zow to Michael Vaughn.
You see, they were both trying to guard Jackson up front and had no idea that Vaughn was all alone in the back of the end zone. Good job by the offensive front. Also, Dustin McClintock on the right side of the line keeping Thomas off of Zow.
Good patience and good vision by the redshirt freshman quarterback for the Crimson Tide, Andrew Zow. His fourth touchdown pass of the season and just the second touchdown reception from Michael Vaughn this year. So Bama covers 80 yards on the touchdown drive, an impressive one. It looked like it may have stalled after the Tide went in reverse for a couple of snaps, but impressive. Capping it off from Zow to Vaughn, and the Tide dominating thus far. Chris Stewart in time of possession, 11:38 to just 5:52. Tide kickoff team, and Southern Miss starts out at its own 13.
Victor Ellis, I believe, also got there to help out. Okay, he got on the pile late, but we're going to give Victor some credit anyway. But a pretty good kick by Wisniewski, getting it to the goal line, and great coverage by the Tide. They worked on that a good bit this week after last week's miscue that really shifted the momentum against Tennessee.
First down for Lee Roberts. Send it over to give to Nix. He pulls his way forward for a couple. Kendall Moorhead, the freshman out of Memphis, makes the tackle for the Tide. Lee Roberts, pretty successful career in Hattiesburg and a proud new papa.
That's right. They paged him, actually paged the manager during practice. He said, "Coach, I got to go. I'm a dad." He got to the hospital, and quite a week for that young man.
Born back on September 15th. Sherrod Gideon, incomplete. The official steps in late. Sherrod Gideon pleading his case, but the officials step in and say it bounced. We'll see if we can pick it up.
I want to see which official makes the call. Gideon with a nice break on Fernando Bryant. That is a catch. And David, if the call was made by the linesman on the near side of the field, he made a big mistake overruling the linesman on the far side of the field. Tough call, but a good break for Bama.
Third down and 8 for the Golden Eagle. Roberts works from the shotgun. Down the field and incomplete, looking for Todd Pinkston. Marcus Spencer with the diving try for the interception, but it short hopped him, and that'll bring up fourth down. a nice series for the Bama defense, getting the ball right back for the Alabama offense.
That's something that hasn't happened as of late. Defense picking up on the momentum created by the offense. Jamie Mercer over to center. Backhand to punt away for Southern Miss. Marvin Richard back deep. Mercer high wobbly kick. Marvin calls for the fair catch. Flag comes in. Danny Fowler and Todd Pinkston both in the neighborhood. And that could be the call, or it may be against the Tide. We'll wait and see. A 39-yard punt. Again, no return after the fair catch by Arvin Richard.
David, I don't know if they're going to call Chad Williams for being inside that 2-yard radius you're supposed to give the return man, but he was blocked into Arvin Richard by, I believe, Reggie Miles. There's no question that there was a Golden Eagle close to Richard, and they are going to call illegal block on Alabama. You said Williams was blocked into Richard. It apparently was a block in the back.
Illegal block in the back by the receiving team. The foul happened after the kick and before the catch, therefore the penalty is enforced from the end of the kick. First down and 10.
Look for number 23 on your screen. Right there, the little push into Williams, and he was in that 2-yard radius initially, but he was pushed from behind into that 2-yard area. Good call by the officials.
So the Tide backed up at its own 37. Sean Alexander, the ball carrier, takes it up. Pickup of about 3 on first down. The Tide done a good job on first down, averaging about 6 yards every first down play.
Sean Alexander
dropped in the backfield. Bama trying to go with the hurry up just a little bit. But Southern more than ready.
Southern Miss has their own Marvin Brown. Number 47, who drops Alexander rather quickly. Good starting situation for Alabama. Not been too successful over the course of the year, but a little bit better in the last 2 or 3 weeks in third and long.
Bama needs 9 yards to keep the drive going. Zow from the shotgun. Enjoying his final appearance of the season at Bryant-Denny.
I would say so. Great pass from Andrew Zow. And I don't know if Vaughn went on the quick out before the streak down the sideline, but there is no way Jose Gonzalez will catch up to Michael Vaughn when he has a couple of steps out in front.
Extra point, and with 10:22 to play in the first half, Bama extends its lead to 17-7.
Tell you what, it's good to see the team respond after a deflating offensive series, really, that consisted of 2 plays for Southern Miss, 2 positive plays for the Golden Eagles that put them on top 7-3. The offense responds. The defense comes up and gives the ball right back to the offense. And something that part of our crack staff has provided us, Halloween woes for Southern Miss, hopefully will continue. They are 2-4 in games played on October 31st, while Alabama seems to like it on Halloween. They're 10-2 coming in.
Scoring drive for Alabama, 3 plays, 63 yards. And of course, the big one. Zow for 62 yards. It ties a career day for Michael Vaughn. Two touchdowns, 33 yards and 62 yards. Alabama leads it by 10.
And I was a little surprised Wisniewski didn't kick it into the end zone on his previous kick, but good foot into that one. Important day in the SEC with a number of games going on, Dave. We've heard a couple of scores. Arkansas leading Auburn by a score of 17-7. Also Ole Miss, an impressive lead, 28-10 over LSU.
Is still up for grabs. If the teams can get some help knocking Arkansas off, it would have helped everyone's cause for Auburn to beat the Razorbacks today, but they aren't 6-0 for nothing.
That's exactly right. Travis Carroll standing in the gap, got some help from Kendall Moorhead after that first run by Derek Nix going for about 9 yards. He's been basically held in check thus far.
They'll give him one on first down, second and 9 from the 21. Roberts checking off. Play clock at 3. Nix bobbled it, but able to pick it up and avoid disaster for Southern Miss.
I thought he double dribbled it, getting to the line of scrimmage, because he was absolutely juggling the football. Let's see if it's a bad handoff. I think he put it on his hip. And that ball may have actually hit the turf. Hard to tell, but definitely not a clean handoff.
He was fighting it for sure, but he managed to keep hold of it. Brandon Francis now into the game in the Southern Miss backfield. And Roberts goes from the shotgun on 3rd and 9. Movement across the front for Bama as a flag comes in. Pinkston on the reception out to the 31, the 32, where Antoine Hunter brings him down. The flag will more than likely be offside against Bama, and I would think Southern Miss would decline it and take the play, which resulted in the first down.
Antoine Hunter was trying to talk the officials into going in the direction of Southern Miss, but that was not the case.
Offside on the defense, penalty refused, first down.
We talk about Sherrod Gideon, but Todd Pinkston, nice receiver as well. Second on the team in receptions with 26 coming into the game. He's averaging 62 yards per game as a receiver. Quite a threat as well.
He's checking off again. Still plenty of time to get it off. Swings it out to Eddie Shaw.
Flag on the play.
Flag comes in from the back judge, and I think they'll blow that play dead.
I think you're exactly right, David. Look, that one's, if the clock hit 0.
Sideline warning on the home team.
Play intended for Eddie Shaw. It never really happened because the flag came in before the snap. The sideline warning against Alabama.
It's our sidelines. By God, we'll stand where we want to. Maybe not.
First and 10 again for Southern Miss. It's on 33. Kenny Smith with some great penetration that time. I think he blew right by Derek Nix.
I thought Kenny was going to take the handoff on this when he got back there so quickly, right up the gut. Nobody touched him. And Trevis Smith really able to make the tackle, but Kenny, you see the reaction, go, where did it go? I went right by it.
Got his sights set on the quarterback. And Nix slipped right by. to the 36, maybe the 37. Travis Carroll wraps him up there. Pickup of about five on the play. Travis Carroll, we talked in the pregame, wanting to have more fun this week in practice. And he said that would lead to more fun in the game and getting more bodies around the football. But Travis walks off favoring that right shoulder just a little bit.
Standing in front of Derek Nix as he's running for the ball doesn't sound like fun to me. Derek Nix, the Golden Eagles, Roberts. Incomplete. Antoine Hunter made a great play there, David, because Pinkston was open, had about a half step, and the ball was thrown nicely, but Hunter reacted tremendously, reaching across with that right hand and knocking away. As we'll see on the replay, they go from the gun. Roberts with time to throw, just wanted to go for a little quick out there and maybe just beyond his fingertips, but Hunter right there on
Purser in to punt it away again. Nice kick this time, tight spiral. Richard looks up into the sun and makes the fair catch at his own 22.
Tough catch. He's coming out of the shadows himself, and that ball, he's looking right back into the sun. That was a nice job by Richard just to feel that one cleanly.
41-yard kick by Purser. And the Tide will take over at its own 22.
They got Southern Miss on the ropes here a little bit. Need to stick another dagger in them right here. Still plenty of time to go in the first half, but you've got some momentum going offensively. We'll see if Alabama can keep it rolling.
Under center this time. Sean Alexander, the ball carrier. Straight ahead running for a couple of yards. Trahan and Gerald Mumford combine on the tackle.
How much room for Sean Alexander? He doesn't need much room, but he does need some. That was just a nice play as coming from the outside was Terrence Parrish out of Theodore, Alabama. Another Alabamian on that USM roster.
Five wideouts now for the Crimson Tide on second and 10. Zow from the shotgun, middle screen to Michael Vaughn. Short gain on the play, a nice clothesline really by Cedric Scott and TJ Slaughter there also. It looked like Vaughn had some room, but one of those guys just stuck out a big paw and brought him down with one arm. It was T.J. Slaughter.
That may be the one guy on that Southern Miss defense that is strong enough to bring down Michael Vaughn with one arm. He is an awfully tough young man. Also didn't help Paul Parker, the center, trying to get out there, and Vaughn actually got in the way of him.
Little or no gain on the play. Brings up third down. Pressure for Zach. Find his running back.
You called it nicely because, as you see, Alexander a little clear across the middle. No, that wasn't a pick from McClintock. But Zow could easily have tucked that thing under and run. Instead, he waited until Alexander came open, flips it at the last minute, and good hands by Sean Alexander just to keep that thing juggled.
Alexander on the toss sweep. Still on his feet. Up near the 15. Larry Watts on the tackle, and he may have made the tackle with Alexander's face mask.
I think you're right. Jeff Bauer doesn't like the call because it came right in front of the Southern Miss bench, and it came late. I think the official just had problems finding the flag in his hip pocket.
After the play was over, there was a personal foul against the defense. 15-yard penalty, automatic.
Kind of late hit. Have to be, but I didn't really notice anything that stood out.
Coach Mike Dubose concerned over his quarterback's treatment last weekend in Knoxville. He did send a tape to the SEC office.
Okay, that's where they're going to call. Spearing, I believe, is the call. Actually throwing that headgear into Sean Alexander. There was not a face mask. They just had him right up around the upper part of the shoulder pad.
Looking for Michael Vaughn, but Larry Watts in the neighborhood as well.
Larry Watts was an eyelash away from going the distance with this one. That's because his eyelashes were not turned towards the quarterback. They were turned towards the intended receiver, Michael Vaughn, but a tough pass from Zow. And look at number 13. He just doesn't see the ball in time. 5 of 15, Zow thus far, throwing the football.
Second down and 10 at the Southern Miss, 37. You see the Golden Eagles shifting the line of defense. Quincy Johnson makes the catch. Short gain on the play to the 35, a pickup of about two when T.J. Slaughter brought him down hard.
That's an athlete. This young man played basketball, and not what you would call a basketball player, but just wreaked havoc on opponents. And he does that, obviously, still in football as well. Tried for the clear out, but nobody bit.
Third and 8 for Bama. Zow trying to set up the screen to Millings, who slipped down as he made the catch. Loss of about a yard on the play, and it'll bring up fourth down and decision time for Coach Mike Dubose.
I think he has decided to go for it. Maybe a little beyond the range of Ryan Flugner, but fourth and 10. See what you can come up with.
Bama on fourth down this year, 3 out of 6. Fourth down and call it 9 yards. Andrews out. And now the flags come in to lay a game. Trying to draw them off sides.
There's a flag on the play.
The Southern Miss coaches were just livid because clock had hit zero a good 3 or 4 seconds, I believe, before they actually called the delay of game penalty. I had no earthly idea Jeff Bauer had that type of vertical jump. That was pretty impressive.
Delay of the game by the offense, 5-yard penalty, fourth down.
He's trying to give Daniel Pope a little more room.
Eddie Shaw, the deep man for Southern Miss, standing at his own 10. Checks up and is touched dead around the 13-yard line. Adam Cox down there to put a hand on it for the Tide. McGehee almost had that one hit him on the head.
It's a good thing Pope went with a wedge that time instead of playing the bump and run into the green. Ball checked up nicely, and I was afraid it was going to go right into the end zone. Probably not a kick he was very happy with, because they try to work more, David, on angling the football. Just go ahead and kicking it out of bounds rather than being concerned about hitting that corner.
First down, Roberts, play action to the boundary. Completes it to Sherrod Gideon.
Lee Roberts pass.
Fernando Bryant. Gimpy hamstring and all, able to make the tackle.
And I think we may have seen the effects of that hamstring. Fernando, when he's healthy, feels like he can run with anybody. And Gideon's great speed, we saw it earlier on that 81-yard touchdown run. He's got to back off of number 11 a little bit here. They're able to throw underneath, respect the speed, and Gideon with a nice pickup, moving the chains for USM.
Pickup of 17 on the play and a first down for Southern Miss. As we near the 2-minute mark here in the first half. Gideon on the slant. And a nice tackle by Tony Gibson, or Gideon may have been off to the races again.
That time Bryant tried to go with a little push right at the line of scrimmage and missed him. And Gideon was able to get the quick burst into the secondary. Roberts catching him there. Again, Fernando Bryant pulling a hamstring badly on Tuesday. Did not practice. It happened late Monday. Did not practice Tuesday or Wednesday, and is not at 100% today.
Under 2 minutes to play now. Clock moving here in the second quarter. Quick play to Eddie Shaw. Dives forward very near the first down marker at the Alabama 41.
It's not a prevent defense that Alabama's in, but they are playing off the receivers a bit at the corners, respecting the speed, not wanting to give up the big play, and Southern Miss is taking what the Alabama defense gives them. See number 99, Darius Gilbert in the game. That's a young man that Mike DeBose has talked a good bit about the last 3 or 4 weeks, wanting to see the true freshman from Oxford get more playing time. Let's take a look at the pressure Alabama gives Southern Miss. Offensive front, not much pursuit. Allowing Roberts to go on the quick out, and you're going to see a lot of helmets swarming the receiver at the end of the play.
Southern Miss takes a timeout with a minute 30 to play here in the first half. Trailing 17-7, they will have two remaining. Alabama with all three of its timeouts still remaining for the final 90 seconds if needed. Roberts, 6 out of 11 for 158 yards so far today for Southern Miss. Not a bad outing, not a great one. If you want to keep up with the Crimson Tide, visit the official athletic site of the University of Alabama, RollTide.com. You can get game stories, listen to the Crimson Tide Sports Network radio broadcast of Bama Athletics, all at RollTide.com. Mike DeBose, I'm sure anxious for the final minute and a half to tick off on the clock and hopefully get into the locker room
without being
leading by 10. First down for the Golden Eagles at the Bama 41. Roberts, deep, looking for Gideon, who makes the catch. Wrapped up at the 10 and brought down by Fernando Bryant. Gideon able to free himself a little bit. Goes up to make the grab. And now the Golden Eagles will have it first down officially at the Alabama 11.
Roberts again with time to throw, throwing off his back foot. You see the matchup. Bryant staying with him. Then a little pitch and go. Bryant got there, but couldn't find the football. And Gideon coming up with another big catch.
Pick up of 30. The play for Southern. Roberts goes into the end zone and throws wide of Todd Pinkston. Marcus Spencer there providing the coverage for the Bama defense.
Tough pass, I would think, to see for Pinkston because, again, the ball's coming from the shadows into that sunlight. A little bit beyond his reach anyway. Would have been an almost impossible catch.
Second down and 10 for Southern at the Alabama 11. Sixth play of the drive coming up for Southern Miss. Looking for Pinkston again. Well wide of the target.
Roberts threw that a little more quickly than he needed to. Cornelius Griffin, number 97, who had a really good first quarter, shot the gap and got to Roberts and forced him to unload it.
Another timeout called by the Golden Eagles. They will have one remaining here in the first half, a minute 12 to play here in the opening 30 minutes of play. The Tide and the Golden Eagles. Jeff Bauer enjoying himself, player for the Golden Eagles, assistant coach, and now head coach. They played a pretty tough schedule thus far. Continuing today with the Tide on the road and the Bama defense huddled around Charlie Harbison and Mike DeBose on the sideline.
Everybody talks about the fact that Alabama is 4-3 right now, which is obviously not where Alabama likes to be. It's not where the Tide is accustomed to being, but you look at the combined record of the three teams that have beaten Alabama, David. You've got an 18-1 mark from those three teams that have beaten Alabama, Arkansas, Tennessee, and the Florida Gators.
coming up at the half. A recap of the first 30 minutes. Interesting feature on the space shuttle, carrying John Glenn, and also an interview with men's basketball head coach Mark Godfrey. Third and 10 for the Golden Eagles. Roberts with time goes into the end zone. Incomplete. Marcus Spencer, I believe, got a hand in to knock it away and save the touchdown.
First, I thought the pass was going to be intercepted, David. Then I thought it was going to be caught. And then a great play at the last minute by Spencer. Watch him come flying in at the last minute over the top. Also got help from Antoine Hunter, able to strip this one away and force Southern Miss to try a field goal.
Hardaway on to attempt a 28-yard field goal. He's made five straight field goals coming into the day. And make it six in a row from 28 yards out. Hardaway bangs it through and trims the Alabama lead to seven at 17-10. 58 seconds to play here in the first half, and an impressive quick drive by Southern right before halftime. Not much pressure by the Bama special teams. And Hardaway knocks it through to make it 17-10.
Two scoring drives that Southern Miss has had have not chewed up much time at all. This one, eight plays, 77 yards, a 140 taken off the clock. They have been a quick strike offense, but that's not unusual for that team. But still, Alabama's got to feel fairly good about the defense inside the 20, able to at least hold Southern Miss to the field goal try, but that's been pretty indicative of Alabama's defense much of the year in the red zone. Opponents have scored 17 of 25 times coming into the game. That's a percentage of 68, but five of those have been field goals. Only 10 rushing touchdowns, a couple of passing scores allowed by the Bama defense in that red zone this year.
Now, a great crowd here at Bryant-Denny. They're standing on the upper deck walkways, peering over. It's an absolutely unbelievable day here in Tuscaloosa. Grant Hanna ready to kick it off. Short sky kick. Millens drifts back to the 11. Spins away from one man. Millens still on his feet out of bounds. Nearly 40-yard line. Chad Williams finally pushed him out of bounds, but an unbelievable return for Freddie Millen.
They got a nice block early from Chris Edwards out of Vesby. See, the number 59 didn't make the clip, and then it's all Freddie Millen's after that. Everybody get out of the way and let him dance a little bit, and gives Alabama great field position. Still plenty of time, 48 seconds on the clock, and the tied with all three timeouts remaining.
As we have said several times, Ryan Pflugner with a very strong leg. Bama really only needs probably 20 to 30 yards to get Pflugner in range and have a decent shot at it. Zow on first down. Buys himself some time. Finds Quincy Jackson, who makes the grab and steps out at the 47. Brian A. Bell on the coverage. Forces him out. 40 seconds to play here in the first half.
Smart play by the senior. Jackson knows he doesn't have much. Zow just buying himself some time. Jackson makes the catch, gets to the boundary.
Second down and three for the tie. The draw to Alexander. Gets away from one man, but can't get away from Cedric Scott. And now Bama will spend the timeout. Trying to catch the Golden Eagles off guard, perhaps, but well read by Cedric Scott.
Sean trying to bounce to the outside, and you don't see that often. One hand bringing Sean Alexander down, but Scott awfully strong. He is fifth on the team in tackles, actually sixth with 44 coming into the contest, but seven of them had been for loss coming into the game.
Bama with two timeouts remaining, one for the Golden Eagles. Sean Alexander, not a bad day thus far, 14 carries for 44 yards. Neil Callaway and Andrew Zow conversing on the Bama sideline.
The number's not tremendous by Sean Alexander's standards, David, but if the passing game continues to succeed, there will be more opportunities for Sean, more running lanes for him in the second half.
33 seconds to go. Bama with the triple stack to the near side. Now on the left finds Jackson, who will have the first down as he steps out at the Southern 49. 27 seconds to play. Deshaun Mallard pushes him out.
You know, it's not all that often that you see trips to one side. It's even more rare that you see the ducks in a row, as I prefer to call them, and it really makes it difficult for the secondary to know which man to pick up as they break from the line of scrimmage.
Bama going with the hurry up. Zow from the shotgun. Plenty of time. Finds Calvin Hall, who races for the boundary and gets out at the 30. Terrence Paris chases him out. But a good pickup for the Tide. They're now in range of Ryan Pflugner.
But you also get a couple of throws towards the end zone. What a great read by Zow. Looked to the right, wanted to go to Quincy Jackson, took his time, found his secondary receiver in Calvin Hall, and Hall very smart, getting the boundary, stopping the clock, and not having to burn a timeout.
Quickly up to the line. Zow from the shotgun to Jackson again. Makes a nice catch, able to get out of bounds and kill the clock at the Southern 17 with 12 seconds to go.
Boy, your options are certainly helped now because you haven't used a timeout. Still two left. Zow getting great protection from the offensive front. And Jackson again getting out of bounds. Look at Hogan and the two guards there, Redmill and McDonald, giving him some time.
Quincy now with at least one catch in 18 consecutive games. First down at the 17, into the end zone, and overthrown. Looking for Michael Vaughn again. He's had the hot hand this afternoon, and Zow looking for him one more time.
Well, Adelius Thomas is the guy that was in Andrew Zow's face, but he may have been the one a little worse for wear. Slow to get up, but now back on his feet, and Alabama's going to try and kick it.
8 seconds to go in the half. Mike Dubose not wanting to take a chance here sends Ryan Pflugner on, and it will be a 34-yard try out of the hold of Daniel Pope. On the way and right down the middle. So Bama answers a quick scoring drive with one of its own. 3 seconds to go before halftime. And the Tide now leading Southern Miss by 10 once again at 20-10.
That was a nice kick from the foot of Ryan Pflugner because Southern Miss got good penetration, but he got the kick up quickly and didn't allow the block. And what a big momentum builder for the Crimson Tide as they go to the locker room. Up 10, you got to feel a little bit better than just that 7-point advantage. I wouldn't say the offense has clicked on all cylinders, but enough to look good here in the first half. Mike Dubose, much publicized, the struggles his team had, especially at home last year. But thus far this season, only the one home loss, and that game went right to the wire against the Florida Gators. Much improved Alabama team, even though the record at this point identical to what we saw a year ago.
Locker rooms. Alabama leads it over Southern Miss as we go to the break. 20-10. Back to Bryant-Denny in just a moment.
Talk to me, lads. unburden yourself. Oh, your silence speaks volumes. You're living a lie, aren't you?
You can't go wrong looking like diet when you taste it more like the regular Dr. Pepper.
Do you feel no remorse? Do you feel no shame?
Oh, boy.
Diet Dr. Pepper tastes more like regular. That's our story, and we're sticking to it.
We welcome you back to Tuscaloosa. David Crane and Chris Stewart at halftime. The Crimson Tide leading it 20-10 over the Southern Miss Golden Eagles. And Alabama jumped out, Chris, to the early 3-0 lead, but just like that, the Golden Eagles responded with the long touchdown pass, and since then it's kind of been back and forth, but Alabama getting the best of it so far.
Yeah, they have gotten the best of it so far. Really can't say enough about the Alabama offense. They scored a field goal in their opening series, but should have had a touchdown. Shamar Buchanan drops a touchdown pass in the end zone. Again, we said it a few moments ago, they haven't clicked on all cylinders, but the offense has looked very impressive. For the most part, so has the defense, but they've given up a couple of big plays, and that has been a real nemesis for Alabama this year themselves, not wrapping up, making plays, and allowing the opponents to sort of stuff them, and then give up the big play.
We'll look at the stats from the first half in just a little bit, but you know without even seeing the stats that the Crimson Tide has done a much better job of picking up first downs on offense.
They have. At one point, I believe the score was 7-3 in favor of Southern Miss, but the first down numbers were 7-3 in favor of Alabama, giving the Alabama defense a chance to rest, building confidence for the Bama offense. Some other things that we can point to without having to see the official numbers is the job that Alabama has done on Derek Nix. He came into the contest, the freshman for Southern Mississippi, rushing for over 100 yards in three consecutive games. After opening the game with a 9-yard burst, he has really been a non-factor since that point.
Two drives, one for each team right before the half, trading field goals. It's good to see that out. The Alabama offense able to answer a score with a score right before half.
It does indeed. It's also great to see Ryan Pflugner open up a half with a field goal and end the half with a made field goal as well. His confidence has to grow, and Alabama's confidence in him has to grow as well.
20-10, Alabama leading Southern Miss at halftime. Again, on hand right at 84,000. Again, watching the Tide today. A look at the SEC scoreboard. Scores from around the Southeastern Conference in the nation. Tennessee, no trouble with South Carolina this afternoon up in Columbia. The Gamecocks' woes continue. This one has gotten a lot closer. It was at one point 17-7. But the Tigers under Coach Bill Oliver coming back strong. And this was an interesting game all day. LSU was favored by 10 going to Oxford. Ole Miss, of course, beating LSU down in Baton Rouge last year. And looks like they're on their way to doing that again. And Vanderbilt trying to make it two in a row.
Break up the Commodores. Two straight, perhaps, today if they could knock off the Dukies.
And Steve Spurrier does not forget. The Bulldogs embarrassed the Gators last year in Jacksonville, and Florida enjoying themselves in the world's largest outdoor cocktail party this afternoon, leading the Bulldogs 21-0. Bama leading at the half, 20-10. A look at some of the highlights from the first half. Crimson Tide jumping out to the early 3-0 lead after the 30-yard field goal from Ryan Pflugner, but very quickly, Southern answers.
Sherrod Gideon, who actually had a pass intercepted in front of him by Reggie Miles on the previous series, taking that one the distance. But Alabama able to answer back. Look at the footwork of Andrew Zow, able to connect on the throw to Michael Vaughn, all alone in the back of the end zone. The Tide back on top.
And Alabama would use the Zow to Vaughn connection again, this time from 62 yards out.
Got a chance to see the speed of Michael Vaughn. Nobody will catch him from behind when he has two steps on a defender.
Southern Miss with a field goal with about a minute to go before halftime, cutting it to a 17-10 lead. But Bama answered with a field goal on the next to last play of the half, and the Tide leads 20-10.
And really, that last field goal was set up by a really nice return on the part of Freddie Millens, giving the Tide some running room.
Southern Miss band entertaining at halftime as well, as we take a look at the SEC standings, including today's games in the Eastern Division. Tennessee absolutely in the driver's seat. The Vols would have to lose twice for either Florida or Georgia to sneak back into the championship game hunt.
SEC East nor the West will be wrapped up today, but as we see now, the Western Division, Arkansas really can go a long way towards determining their fate for the rest of the year if they can hang on against Auburn. And still a tough test at Knoxville, but they really hold their fate in their own hands.
If the Razorbacks can win today, they are in awfully good shape the rest of the way. Mike Dubose on the Bama sideline as the Crimson Tide will have the football to begin the second half. Bama won the toss and deferred. Brant Hanna set to kick it away. Auburn Richard drifts a couple of yards deep, and he will bring it up to the top. In front of the 10. And Brant Hanna moves. Not the ball decision that time for Arvin Richard to bring it out. And the Tide will be backed up deep to start the second half.
Not the best of decisions, as you said, and then tried to dance around a little bit instead of just getting upfield. And one of the few mistakes we've seen Arvin make in the kicking game the last couple of weeks.
So Bama takes over. Andrew Zow's numbers to this point. Pretty good day for the redshirt freshman thus far. Let's see if he can keep up the good work in the second half. Sean Alexander trips as he gets the handoff from Zow. They may have tripped one another, and it'll be a loss on the play.
Just couldn't keep his feet, and I don't know that this play was going to go for more than a couple of yards anyway, but he did have the numbers on that right side with Montoya Madden and Justin McClintock in there, the power look from Alabama.
Loss of a couple. Second and 12 now. Football sitting on the Alabama 8-yard line. Works from the shotgun. Under pressure, now he steps up and has some running room. Picks up a nice drop from Quincy Jackson as he rolls out of bounds at the 15-yard line. So a heads-up play by Andrew Zow and a helping hand from Quincy Jackson.
Well, it got the job done, but it was awfully disappointing. I mean, he had the angle on Brian Bell, and everybody's ready to go, okay, it wasn't that impressive. Normally, they're coming to their feet on a block like that, but he just sort of bumped him, but it did get the job done. And Zow, what a great read. Go ahead and tuck it under and run, and almost made the Golden Eagles look like the Keystone Cops, everybody colliding and meeting at the end zone. But Zow was long gone.
Picked up about 7 yards, and it brings up 35 for the Tide. Arvin Richard on the catch. Brought down by Adelius Thomas, and he is right at the first down marker. We'll see if he gets the favorable left foot spot and the first.
It's a tough catch for Arvin Richard. He's just made his break, running away from Andrew Zow, but brings it in and gets close enough, there's going to be a measurement. Punting team had already come back, had come onto the field for Alabama, and then they stopped and realized this one was going to be close.
Have to bring the chains all the way over from the far side. Yep. And it is a first down.
First down.
So Bama trying to work its way out of a hole to start here in the second half. And the Tide, as we mentioned, a nice job picking up the first downs today, moving the chains and hanging on to the ball, resting what is, worth repeating, a very banged up defensive unit.
Bama has doubled up Southern Miss on first downs and, more importantly, on the scoreboard as well. That's a 20-10 score.
Deep tackle. Andrew Zow floats it deep. Calvin Hall runs underneath, and he picks up 44.
It wasn't textbook. Great fake first off from Zow, putting it on his hip. Southern Miss trying to get a hand in the face of Zow, and Dustin McClintock thought this pass was intended for him. He had two receivers in the area, an almost disaster, but still, play goes for big yardage, and Hall able to get upfield in a hurry afterwards.
The offense shifts for the Tide. Marvin Brown ahead of Alexander, who gets the call. Falls forward to about the 35, maybe a pickup of a half yard. Cedric Scott got good penetration that time for Southern Miss. Not much running room today for Sean Alexander. Obviously trying to minimize his impact and make Andrew Zow win the game.
He has not had the great numbers, but it's still a situation where obviously Southern Miss has to respect Sean Alexander being in the ball game, and that is a lot for Andrew Zow to throw the ball effectively.
The reverse to Jason McCaffrey. And McCaffrey may have lost the yard. Brian Azell right there to make the tackle.
Southern
Golden Eagles weren't cool that time.
No, they defensed it nicely, but I think you have to lay some of the blame on McCadley for just not turning it upfield and getting as much as possible. Only one blocker out there. McCadley sort of dancing around, not running with the same authority that we've seen Eric Locke or Freddie Millens in that situation at times this year. But he's another youngster that hasn't had many opportunities like that, if any, thus far this year.
Third down and 11 for the Titans. And an 8 out of 11 today. Tim Bowens, the junior from Killen, Alabama. He doesn't have a whole lot of receptions in his Bama career, but in this offense, everybody's going to get their shot.
Great pass again from Zow. Deshaun Mallard was there, and then late Larry Watts made the tackle, and Bowens wrapping it up nicely, but that was hit right in the number 8. Huge day, as we see already, from Zow over the 300-yard mark.
Inside the 10 before he's brought down. And the Tide putting together a nice drive to start the second half.
Straight handoff up the gut. Sean just bouncing his way through, trying to pick up some yardage, and it doesn't at the time appear to be much, but all of a sudden you look up and it's a gain of 5, maybe 6. Alabama has not scored a touchdown in the red zone throwing the football this year, David. All 10 touchdowns that have been scored coming in this game have come on the ground.
And puts it back to Sean this time. Inside the We touched on it last week, Chris. The third quarter has not been a good one for Bama. They've been outscored 53-28 this season, but they've got an awfully good-looking drive going right now.
They've come out flat in those games, and that has not been the case. You can bet the Alabama coaching staff challenging their players to come out with a quick start. What an impressive drive for the Tide offense here to start this third quarter. Now they've got to finish it off. Number 3, the power formation.
Straight ahead. Maybe to the 2.
Wouldn't be surprised, David, to see some sort of bootleg in this situation, or even maybe the option look with Andrew Zow to take advantage of his speed. This is a guy who not only threw for over 1,000 yards as a high school junior, but also rushed for over 1,000 yards. And you see a lot of time already taken up here in the start of the third quarter. But this is where the versatility of Andrew Zow really can come into play.
Terrence Parrish forced him out, and a nice job by the Golden Eagle defense of stringing it out.
And Ty Trahan, number 16, just following the play. And then also you see Terrence Parrish cutting off the pylon. And Sean just couldn't get his shoulders turned upfield and get into the end zone.
Third down and go.
right half the line of scrimmage. T.J. Slaughter, the linebacker, got in there and caused some havoc, but it was actually Gerald Mumford, defensive lineman out of Jackson, Mississippi, who made the first hit, and Mike DuBose says, we're going to go for it. They need a yard for the touchdown. Nobody out there. Mark Godfrey had to like that one. That was two on one for Alabama's receivers. One defensive back. Nobody coming out to help. And great observation on the part of Andrew Zow. The first passing touchdown in the red zone for Alabama this year.
An impressive drive. Over 6.5 minutes off the clock as Ryan Flutner packs on the extra point. And Alabama takes it 90 yards to start the second half. And another look at the touchdown. Chris Stewart, you could have caught this one.
Well, let's not stretch it, but I at least like would have liked my chances there. Boy, nobody out there. Zal, you could tell he just wanted to hurry up and get the snap so he could get it into the hands of Michael Vaughn. Don't you know that John Thompson, the assistant head coach and defensive coordinator for the Golden Eagles, has got to be pulling his hair out in the booth. Here you are. You have stuffed Alabama on three straight plays when they've gone with their power look. And instead they throw a little dink pass and score on fourth and goal.
One of those things, you know, Andrew Zow didn't want to look too excited when he looked down there and saw Michael Vaughn uncovered. Don't do anything stupid to tip your hand. There's the scoring drive for the Tide. 13 plays, 90 yards, 6:34 off the clock. And one of the easiest touchdown passes Andrew Zow may ever have.
You're exactly right. You know, isn't it amazing? We talk so much about the importance of field position and pinning the opposition deep. Southern Miss gets their only touchdown in this game, starting literally inside their own 1 yard line. 2 plays later, they're in the end zone. Alabama comes out to start the second half. They go 90 yards.
Turn. Miguel Merritt finally brings him down as he takes it across the 25, so a good return for Francis, and Southern Miss will have the football for the first time here in the second half, trailing it now 27-10.
We may see Miguel Merritt more in the next couple of weeks other than just the special teams roles. He's with the injuries that have depleted Alabama somewhat. Canary Knight, we mentioned early, suspended for one game due to team rules that were broken and not there, and could see Miguel Merritt more today on defense.
Lee Roberts, not a great first half, not a bad one. Goes with Derek Nix on first down. Steve Stanley there to make the tackle, and Stanley seeing more playing time today after the suspension of Canary Knight for one game after missing too many classes, according to head coach Mike DuBose.
Three strikes and you're out in baseball. Three missed classes and you're out one game. The team rule for the Crimson Tide. And a good one.
Pick up a four-on play. Roberts checking off. But in the meantime, play action. Completes it to Kingston, who's wrapped up and brought down immediately by Reggie Miles.
The freshman getting a lot of playing time. We talked about it. Fernando Bryant not at 100%. They're counting on him more at a corner, even with Bryant in the game. But he has stepped up. He's already had one interception. A good open field tackle here. Pinkston has the size advantage, but Miles wrapping him up, taking him down, and bringing up third and short.
A final from just across the state. Hard-fought game, but the Razorbacks stay undefeated under first-year head coach Houston Nutt. Third down and three. Swing it out into deep. Looking for his tight end, Antonio Franklin, but just out of his reach. And the Golden Eagles go three and out.
6'5", 263. Antonio Franklin, not an easy target to miss, but Roberts' pass just too high, and Alabama fans giving the Tide defense a nice round of applause. And again, nice to see them come up with a stop after the offense puts points on the board.
Jamie Purser back in, averaging 39 yards, and it's a pick. Michael Villalonga for the Golden Eagles with an open running lane up the sideline, finally pushed out at the Bama 43 by Arvin Richard. But Jeff Bauer rolls the dice and comes up big on the fake punt.
So they get 22 on the play, and Warren Faust, just before the snap, I don't know if he is the last man on the outside, but he jumps towards the inside, and you see both he and Chris Ryer get caught to the inside. Good job by Southern Miss. And Faust came back in late, but it was way too late to prevent the first down.
Gideon, who's got it, pushed out at the Bama 23 by Fernando Bryant. Pickup of 19 on the play.
Had one-on-one coverage across the way as Bryant trying to guard Gideon. They've been battling all day. Gideon makes a little fake to the inside, and you see Fernando trying to get back in the play because he bit on the post route. Instead, Gideon goes to the boundary, and a nice pass from Roberts. Boy, after making a big play with special teams, Lee Roberts like an assassin, answering back quickly. First down for Southern Miss. Roberts gets the throw again. Kendall Moorhead in pursuit. Roberts into the end zone, incomplete.
Dixon and Bryant double teaming Kevin Hurd, the senior from West Point, Mississippi, just out of his reach.
Tony Dixon having to step up his play, just a sophomore out of Pickens County High School, but with the loss of Kelvin Sigler for the year, Tony Dixon becoming an even more valuable part of the Tide secondary. Didn't deflect the ball, but was in position if the throw had been a little bit closer to the receiver.
Second play of the drive coming up. Lee Roberts checked off. Second time today, Nix has had a little trouble getting the handle, and fortunate again to fall on it.
Chris Horn was right there on the play. You see Horn going on the blitz, but that's the second time we've seen the mishandle, and looked like Roberts made a nice handoff, but Nix may be looking ahead instead of getting the ball tucked away first.
Third down and 11 for the Golden Eagles. UF team only 3 out of 8 on third down today. Bama puts 11 men at the line of scrimmage. From the shotgun, Roberts under pressure completes the pass over the middle, but it will be shy of the first down. Sherrod Gideon makes the grab down at the 15, but that's about 2 yards short of the first down marker. Fernando Bryant and Owen Winston combining to make the stop.
But obviously advantage there of having two guys that have played together quite a bit, quarterback Lee Roberts and Sherrod Gideon. You could tell there was not going to be a lot of time, and Roberts able to get it off, but still not enough for the first down.
Tim Hardaway into the game to attempt a 32-yarder. It's another play. And the Golden Eagles take it down to the Bama 1. Derek Nix on the fake. And Jeff Bauer dips into his bag of tricks for the second time on one drive. And it's now first and goal.
You know, you would think this is a conference game. Both coaches just rolling the dice. Lots of gadget plays, and Southern Miss trying to swing the momentum back in their favor, getting a touchdown. They give it to Nix. A great pitch from Purser. And Alabama just barely able to keep Nix out of the end zone.
So it's first and goal at the one. Dwayne Wood in the backfield with Derek Nix. Nix gets the call, and Nix is in for a touchdown.
I don't think it was second effort. I think it took third effort on the part of Nix just to push his way in. And again, you have to tip your hat to Jeff Bauer. This is a man who has never beaten the University of Alabama as a player at Southern Miss. nor as a head coach. And he's tired of coming close. He wants to get a victory and trying to make sure he gives his team every opportunity to do so.
The Golden Eagles claiming Alabama their most hated nemesis. Coming close so many times, but Alabama leading the series 27-5 with two ties. Tim Hardaway adds the extra point, and a frustrating drive for the Alabama defense. The Tide thought they had it stopped twice, and yet they give up the touchdown.
We talked about the need for consistent play in special teams. For the most part, Alabama's gotten that, as you see Nicks again with a second and third effort. Also got a nice lead block from the little man, Dwayne Woods, only 5'7", 189, and a redshirt freshman out of Slidell, Louisiana, but giving Nicks just enough room to get into the end zone. David, I don't recall another series in college football that's more one-sided record-wise and yet been more competitive than this one between Alabama and Southern Miss over the years.
Yeah. Bauer pulling out all the stops, and could we see an onside kick?
Well, they have faked the punt, then faked the field goal. That would be the last in the trilogy as far as the fakes are concerned. But
maybe pull out the spot pass on the kick return. Who knows? There's the scoring drive for Southern Miss, an impressive one, answering Alabama's touchdown drive to start the second half, and it's back to a 10-point lead for the Tide. Hanna boots it away. Evan Richard. A.I.D. brings it out. Across the 20. Still on the field, across the 30. Up to the 35. Marvin Richard, number two in the Southeastern Conference in kickoff return. Showed why there. A yard deep, he brings it out 36 yards to the 35.
At first, I thought Darius Gilbert, number 99, was going to screw this up. There he is getting in the way, but yet it almost gave Arvin enough time to move through a little bit more, picked up an additional 10 yards. And again, Arvin Richard and the special teams unit giving the Alabama offense good field position.
Zow starts this drive under center. Swings it off to Quincy Jackson. Trying to help him out down there, and a good pickup on first down.
David, watch Andrew Zow throw this ball over the top of the defensive end. The first 2 weeks of the season, the first 2 weeks that he played, these passes were being deflected, but he's put a little air under them now, and a nice job of running with the football by Quincy Jackson after the reception.
Pickup of a little better than 5 yards, and a busy afternoon for that man. 6 catches already, and we still have about 18 minutes of playing time left. From the shotgun on second down, Zow to play. Again to Jackson. He picks up the first down just across the 45. T.J. Slaughter there to bring him down, but it's another Bama first down.
Had Calvin Hall going deep on this play as Bama goes from the gun, but Zow looks right and then instead goes to the man underneath. Jackson now with 7 catches on today. Downfield in a hurry.
Sean Alexander gets the carry. Dancing through some traffic. Andrew Zow's numbers today, 24 of 30, 340 yards and 3 touchdowns. No interceptions, and we've still got a full quarter to play. The last time Bama had a 300-yard passing game, back in 1994 against Mississippi State. So it's been a while, and
it's been
400 is well within his reach.
Feeling may need it before today is through.
On second down and 6. Sean Alexander would have been dancing in the end zone.
Well, Andrew got clocked. He had to throw this one just a hair quicker than he would have liked, because I believe it was Adelius Thomas again breathing down his neck. And a good try by Sean. He's made some nice catches today, but just couldn't quite come up with that one. Southern Miss, good pressure on their defensive front.
forcing Alabama to hurry that pass, or it would have been six for the Crimson Tide.
So a big third down for Bama. Possession play. The Tide needs to take it to the Southern Miss 25. Zow throws incomplete. Looking for Eric Locke.
One of the few poor passes we've seen Andrew make today, but also one of the few opportunities Eric Locke has had to maybe make a tough play and not come up with it. You'll see a little bit low as Locke goes a little quick. They clear out for him with Calvin Hall going deep, but need to come up with that play. I don't think it would have been enough for the first down, even if he makes the catch, however.
Would have been tough to pick up the first. Ryan Flugner back on. This time a 39-yard field goal attempt. 49 yards, excuse me. No good. He had the distance, but it faded off just to the right. So Flugner misses from 49 yards out, and the Golden Eagles will take over with a minute 13 to play here in the third quarter. So in tennis terms, the Golden Eagles, the first team to break serve here in the second half. Another good-looking drive by Bama, but the Tide couldn't finish it off.
That last kick by Flugner was missed to the right. Obviously, Mike DuBose wants to see him make every kick, but he says, you know, if he misses it right, I can live with it. It's when he, and again, you can tell Mike loves to play golf during the offseason because he always uses putting analogies. This is like missing a putt to the high side. At least it's got a chance to come back. If you miss it left, it has no chance of getting back to the uprights. If you're right, pretty quick.
First down for the Golden Eagles.
Bryant won't admit it after the game, but I can't help but think he is feeling the effects of that hamstring pull. Having to play off of Sherrod Gideon and also not able to react as quickly after Gideon makes the catch. You see, not too often does a receiver go past Fernando Bryant in that fashion, but he has been able to do it a couple of times this afternoon.
A little antsy for Alabama.
I would say so. Slight understatement there.
Before the snap, the defense violated the neutral zone.
Cornelius Griffin, the first man to buckle. And the 5-yard step off takes it to the Bama 49, where it'll be first and five. Griffin having a pretty good day, the junior college transfer, the leading tackle for Alabama this afternoon. Penalties have been a problem for the Tide this season, but a much better job today. Knicks inside the 40, where Darius Gilbert brings him down, and he'll have another first down.
Offensive front for Southern Miss doing a nice job. A lot of running room for Derek Nix.
First down at the Bama 39. The tackle, but that's going to be another Southern Miss first down.
Eddie Shaw is a senior. It is kind of amazing to think of. Coming into last week's game, he had 70 career receptions and 18 career punt returns, but he had never scored a touchdown until last week. I guess his career has been made up of plays like this, getting things underneath and still getting up for a first down. Very effective, as you see.
Chris, Derek Nix straight ahead, and what a shootout that turned out to be at Vaught-Hemingway Stadium, and tip of the hat to Tommy Tuberville and Ole Miss. Two straight wins over LSU. We have come to the end. Sun beginning to set, the moon already out here in Tuscaloosa as we head to the fourth and final quarter. Alabama leading the Golden Eagles 27-17. And what was, to say the least, an exciting third quarter between these two clubs. You wouldn't know it by them, but it was an exciting third quarter.
They were down on the edge of their seats, weren't they?
The Golden Eagles face a second and five when play resumes. And the Bama fans trying to make a little noise. Roberts works from the center. Down the boundary and incomplete. Gideon, the intended receiver. Fernando Bryant watching him down the sideline.
Tony Dixon coming over to help out, also showing nice restraint because he could have taken Gideon's head off if he wanted to. Little man coverage there, a little quick move to the outside by Gideon. And
thought Tony Dixon might get over there in time to try and pick it.
Kendall Moorhead, David, were putting pressure on Roberts there and forced him to unload pass maybe a half count earlier than he would have liked. See again the pressure applied by Stennis coming up the middle. Moorhead from the outside, and Bama again forcing Southern Miss to try a field goal.
A 40-yard attempt for Tim Hardaway, and let's see if they actually kick it.
Right. Chedrick Blackman, not a happy man. Reggie Miles, I think, will learn next time in those situations just to go down. But the kick was blocked by Kenny Smith. A big play. Made a huge play last year in the game, David, where things had really switched in favor of Southern Mississippi in the contest, and yet the Tide able to get a play from Kenny Smith, turn the momentum back in favor of Alabama. See Miles going the other way, but coming in late, Shedrick Blackman squashing him. I think
during
the best way to explain it.
Of the block field goal, or there was a block below the waist by the receiving team. The penalty will be assessed from the spot of the foul, half the distance to the goal, first and 10.
So a costly penalty following the block.
Smith just going right up the middle. Miles trying to get a little something extra.
You saw his teammates trying to wave him off, but Miles wanted to make something to happen, tried to make something happen. Near the 18-yard line. Pickup of 7 on first down, and we'll keep an eye on the Bama sideline to see if and when Reggie Miles starts breathing again after Shedrick Blackman lowered the boom on him after the block field goal. Second down and three for the Tigers. Picks up the first down. T.J. Slaughter makes the stop.
It's interesting to see if Alabama turns conservative offensively, David. And while Andrew Zow has had a big game, will they put the ball in the hands of that man the rest of the way? Sean Alexander, hope they've worn Southern Miss down enough. Just do it on the ground. But boy, what a day he has had. Andrew Zow, over 300 yards passing. In fact, coming into the quarter, 340 yards.
Tripped up by Ty Trahan and Larry Watts.
Alexander's numbers coming into the quarter, not that great, just 23 carries for just 64 yards. But he's a guy that gets stronger as the day goes on and got good help, you see, from Montoya Madden, number 21, Dustin McClintock, number 30. You'll be surprised to see those two guys in there a good bit today.
Three-piece buster to the century mark this afternoon for Sean Alexander. Pick up a few yards on the play before John Nix puts the stop on him.
Afraid that was going to get knocked out. As we'll see Nix make the tackle as I believe Alexander was trying to shift the football from his left arm to his right. But good cutback by Sean. The veteran running back putting the ball away.
Third down and 2 yards for Bama. Mike Dubose would love to see a nice long drive result. But it may not happen this time. Alexander stuck by T.J. Slaughter. And he will be shy of the first down.
T.J. Slaughter is a good one. We told you coming in, by far the leading tackler on this Alabama football team. But nobody blocked him.
So it'll be fourth down now for Alabama. Daniel Pope into the game to punt it away. Eddie Shaw back deep for Southern Miss. Slight breeze at his back. Comes up to the 31. Up to the 37-yard line. Chad McGehee, our man on special teams, once again makes the tackle.
Well, he fell off a blocker to do it. Really a good play by Chad in special teams. But we say that just about every punt from Daniel Pope. That good play made by the senior from Southside High School in Rainbow City, Alabama.
There you see the time remaining. Bama leads it 27-17.
Jay Slaughter's the guy that made the play, but I don't know if you're able to see the right side. John Nix almost bent backwards in two on the play.
On first down, the option by Southern Miss to pick back to Derek Nix. Gilbert and Moorhead played it well. Made the stop after a pickup of about two.
We'll say the game's in the hands of the defense, but they certainly have an opportunity to shut the door here. If you turn Southern Miss away, don't allow any points. You've got to think, as the clock now ticks near the 11-minute mark, that things would be in hand for the Crimson Tide.
Second down and eight. Fernando Bryant out of the game. Mishandled snap. But Roberts able to fall on it. Third time there's been a mishandled ball in the Southern Miss backfield. Maybe not a clean exchange that time.
Not at all. Frank Firestone, I believe, snapped the football before Lee Roberts was ready. And Southern Miss very fortunate to get that one back, but they're put in a third and long situation.
Southern Miss facing third and long, not very effective today. And they'll blow the play dead.
Alabama's really been one of their worst enemies with the penalty department this year, and I'm afraid that's the case again. You take a third and nine and maybe make it a third and four. Although they are talking to the Alabama captain, so it was apparently procedure against Southern Miss.
The defense violated the neutral zone rules, causing the offense to get a move by a ruler about 5 yards against the defense. Repeat third down.
It may be the rule, but it's not a popular call here in Tuscaloosa.
Rule schmules. Let's take a look at it. Yep, you're going to see the left guard there on the play. Jeff Hopgood did indeed move, but it was after Kenny Smith broke the neutral zone.
Officially now third and four for the Golden Eagles. Wallace being chased out. Incomplete. Gideon and Pinkston both in the neighborhood. Not exactly sure who he was throwing to. It was almost in between the two of them.
All Lee Roberts was concerned with was how do I get away from Clint Wagner. Big number 91. I haven't called his name much today, but inserted in passing situations, makes a nice play, putting pressure on Lee Robertson again. The Eagles forced to punt.
Pressure back in. You have to hold your breath every time the Southern Miss special teams comes out. Arden Richard to deep man, and they're going to try and take it again down the sideline, but it is caught by Danny Fowler. Michael Fagan had some pretty good coverage, and we couldn't get it out of our mouth good before they pull another fake out of the bag.
I don't know if Michael even realized he was in coverage. Perhaps the sidelines, as I'm sure they were, hollering to let him know there's a pass, but got there at the last minute, but it was too late. And what a throw on the part of Jamie Purser, the punter out of Red Bay, Alabama. Another from this state. And again, Jeff Fowler, 1997 Conference USA Coach of the Year. Not afraid to roll the dice, but not a lot to lose when you're down 10 and under 2 minutes to go.
Golden Eagles champions of Conference USA last year, playing in the Liberty Bowl. Into the end zone, incomplete. Pinkston made the grab, but I believe he came down out of bounds.
And Reggie Miles is actually hung on the fence, the quarterback, after coming over and making a stop. Now he's loose, but good coverage by Miles, and Pinkston goes up and makes a great effort. He just ran out of real estate. Roberts with time to throw. You see Miles there. Pinkston goes up, makes the catch, but he was out of bounds, as you see. Great camera angle there.
Came down on the line, bobbled it, able to bring it in, but he was out of bounds. Second down, 10. Roberts, the screen up the middle.
That's a nice call. I don't think we've seen that little underneath screen from Southern Miss. We've seen it from Alabama a good bit this year. But Tito Smith, number 89, on the blitz, makes the pass. And then a good job by Kendall Moorhead. Down lineman going back to make the stop. Also got help from the linebacker, Steve Stanley, coming up to make the play. And another big third down situation here.
Third down and nine. The Bama fans come to their feet, and Lee Roberts wants a timeout. He was about to get hit by the 25-second clock, saw it just in time, and used a timeout. 8:51 to play in the game. Bama hanging on to a 10-point lead over the Golden Eagles as Roberts heads to the sideline to visit with his head coach. Back to Bryant-Denny in a moment. Lee Roberts, Jeff Bauer talking it over. A big third down play upcoming for Southern Miss. It's third and nine at the Alabama 26. 8:51 to play in the game. The Golden Eagles. Trying to get out of trouble. And Eddie Shaw thought he was going to try and set up the screen at first, but there was nobody underneath, and he found somehow or another Eddie Shaw come unguarded.
You're exactly right. That did look like the screen the whole way, and Alabama's corners may have actually responded as though it were a screen. Reggie Miles breaking to the inside, and then a nice grab by Southern Miss, and they've got first and goal.
At the Bama 4 for Southern Miss. Nick in the backfield gets the call, and he is stopped right at the line of scrimmage by Trevis Smith.
Cornelius Griffin got through the line quickly, but you're right. It was Trevis Smith that made the hit. That's a lot of force combining and meeting right at the 3-yard line between Nix and Trevis Smith.
Nix able to muscle his way forward for a yard on the play. 18 carries for 41 yards on the afternoon for the Acela native there.
Case for pass interference, but he was trying to cut to the inside, it appeared. Officials, I believe, ruling that this pass was uncatchable, and you're right, Sherrod, he did grab your jersey.
A lot of contact between the two players, but he did have a handful of jersey, and that may be the first time all year that Fernando Bryant gotten away with something. Is no walk in the park for Bama. The Golden Eagles 3 for 3 on fourth down so far today. Another look.
Pinkston should have had that football. I don't know if it would have been a touchdown even if he makes the catch. Couldn't tell about his feet, but they missed Sherrod Gideon to the right. He was wide open on the right side of the end zone.
All the way in to attempt a 20-yard field goal.
Perhaps.
And it's good. So with 7:28 to play in the game, the Golden Eagles crawl to within a touchdown at 27-20.
I just feel the need to add perhaps to the end of every call, it seems, in special teams as of late for Southern Miss. They've rolled the dice so often in this second half, but obviously there, Jeff Bauer just wanted a point, pleading his case. He said, man, we should have had a touchdown or a pass interference call on Gideon. But, he's not going to get the call changed. He's just working on the next one.
Jeff Bauer not exactly thrilled with the officiating. But to be quite honest, that man hasn't been thrilled with the officiating his club has gotten throughout the course of this season either. Regardless, 27-25 pay-per-view in the state of Alabama, state of Mississippi, and the alumni groups all across the United States joining us this afternoon.
Brad Peter in the kickoff for Southern Miss. Freddie Miller and Arvin Richard from the seat.
Feast or famine for Arvin today in returns. He's either been stopped inside the 15 or gotten out beyond the 30, it appears. Take a look at the touchdown play. The return again, and Richard running a long way only to get to about the 15-yard line.
Jose Gonzalez, a nice job of getting a hold of the jersey and not letting go. So Bama starts out on its own 13, nursing a 7-point lead. Quincy Jackson up near the 25 and close to a first down to Sean Mallard. Pushed him out of bounds. And Chris, we were talking in the break. Alabama so successful for the most part today through the air. Do you go conservative and give it to Sean Alexander here in the fourth and try and work on the clock? Or do you stick with what has been so successful to this point.
Well, you can throw the football and still be conservative. You can throw the out routes and tell the freshman quarterback, we don't want anything forced. If it's not there, throw it away. 7:09, still a lot of time to play. You can't just put it on the ground and hope to run out the clock.
It is a first down for the Tide.
Got a great job of blocking on the left side. Montoya Madden, Dustin McClintock running interference as well as the left side of the Bama line. And Sean just gets stronger as the game develops.
And the success for the most part this season has come over that left side behind preseason All-America Chris Samuels and the left guard Griff Redmill. They go right this time with Alexander. He takes it up to the 44-yard line. Alexander over the 100-yard mark for the fifth time this season. Now 30 carries for 107 yards. 30 carries, a career high for him.
30 carries, really something that Mike DeBose will love to see. He wanted the football. He said coming into the season, we want to see Sean Alexander handle the football 25 to 30 times. And he said, I want to see it closer to 30 than closer to 25.
Closing in on the six-minute mark here in the fourth quarter. Takes it to the southern 45 and has another first down.
You got 5:54 on the clock. You've got a 7-point lead, and the redshirt freshman's confidence has grown. So what the heck? Let's throw a bullet across the middle to a true freshman, nonetheless, in Freddie Millins. And those two have hooked up a number of times today, and what a weapon they have been together.
What numbers for Andrew Zow. A pickup of 11 and another first down.
Bama throws it, sets up the run. Great blocking again up front. The big horse is doing the job, and Sean certainly knows what to do with it after he gets into the open field.
Clock rolling, nearing the five-minute mark. Alexander now at 117 yards on the day. He gets it one more time. Cuts it up in the middle. Inside the 30 to the 27. Sean Alexander, 32 carries now, and I'm sure he could handle it about 10 more times.
What a nice cut. Just let Paul Hogan clear his man out. And we talk about it. Just gets stronger and stronger as the game develops. 32 carries, 123 yards. He would like to get a touchdown, though. He's at zero right now.
4.5 minutes to go. Clock on the move. Bama leading by 7. Trying to put it away. Alexander sprinting outside, able to turn the corner. Slides out of bounds. He stayed in at the 18, but that's good for the first down.
Watch number 47. Coming up on replay, Marvin Brown from Southern Mississippi. Looks as though he's going to make the play on Sean Alexander, but Sean just able to brush him off as if he's a child trying to make the stop. Smart enough to get down and not stop the clock. What a smart play by the junior.
They stop it momentarily to reset the chains after the first down, but it will start, and we're now under 4 minutes to go. And Bama will take a timeout. Play clock winding down. Mike Dubose, you saw on the sideline signaling for the timeout. His quarterback finally got the message, and Bama avoids the delay of game penalty and uses its first timeout of the second half. 3:54 to play in the game, and Alabama leads it by a touchdown.
We've seen Andrew Zow gain confidence over the last few weeks. We've seen him make good decisions. And I think maybe a few years from now you will point to October 31st, 1998 as a breakout day for Andrew Zow as the Crimson Tide's quarterback. See the timeouts remaining even at 2 apiece. 340-plus yards for Sean Alexander, or excuse me, for Andrew Zow at 1 point. I'm not certain what his most recent numbers are.
I believe he's up past about 360 now.
Last time a
quarterback that Alabama threw for 400 yards in a game was Scott Hunter. 30 for 55, 484 yards. And I would imagine if he's here right now, Scott Hunter is reminding the folks in the press box that he did that.
I would imagine he is. Ninth play of the drive coming up for Bama. Trying to cash it in. McClintock and Madden both in the game in front of Alexander. Flag coming in. Sean takes it over the left side. Loses the football. Southern Miss has fallen on it, but there is a flag on the play, and I believe the Golden Eagles jumped offside.
I think it was Adalius Thomas that jumped. There was definite movement, but let's see if he was drawn offside. Alabama may have caught a break.
Steve Landis, our referee.
Boy, Thomas is already pointing to himself. This is my fault. You know, that's got to make him sick.
Offside, on the defense, 5-yard penalty. It's his first down.
Eager to make the play. Again, playing in his home state. And just jumps the gun. And it may have cost Southern Miss one last opportunity and getting the football back with time. Sean doesn't fumble it much.
First and five now at the 14. McClintock man in motion to give to Alexander. Straight ahead. Alexander takes it down to the 8-yard line and is very close to another first down.
Sean doing a better job of hanging on to the football. They're just trying to pull it away as they get him in a pile. You know, David, this is something that Alabama has done very well offensively this year. When they catch a break, when they've turned it over only to have the ball come back because of a penalty, they have gone on and scored points most of the time this year, and hopefully that will be the case this afternoon.
3:33 to play in the game, and Southern Miss takes a timeout. They have one remaining, beginning to battle not only Alabama but the clock as well. They trail by seven, and Alabama will have first and goal at the Golden Eagle 8 when play resumes. Coming up for Alabama next week, the Tide will head to Baton Rouge, which LSU, an up and down season to say the least. Losing today in overtime in Oxford to Ole Miss. Alabama, of course, hasn't lost in Baton Rouge in about 30 years, so the Tide will try and keep that streak going. Then it's on to Starkville to play a very big, a very physical Mississippi State team before wrapping up the regular season in Birmingham against Auburn, and certainly that game has a more interesting twist to it now.
I would think so, with Brother Bill Oliver, former Alabama defensive coordinator. Now the interim head coach.
Toss sweep. Alexander looking for some running room. Falls forward to about the 6. Adalius Thomas makes the stop, but the clock continuing to roll.
I think we'll just show restraint on that. How about that?
Happy Halloween, everyone. Zow and the offense in no hurry. They break the huddle with 10 seconds. Up to the line with 5. Under 3 minutes to play now. Zow to give to Alexander. Running wide. Alexander cuts it off. Brought down at the 4.
And Sean gets up the head of steam and turns the corner. Normally, you can't keep him out. But Southern Miss making a nice play.
And maybe a little fatigue beginning to set in. He has been a workhorse, especially here in the
fourth quarter. He does get stronger as the game progresses, but it has not exactly been like taking candy from a baby for Sean Alexander on this series.
Oh, no.
Well, he said
third and goal at the 4. Zow breaks in motion. Zow runs out to throw.
Andrew was just scrambling, trying to create something. something there, but he had Calvin Hall wide open in the back of the end zone. It's hard to fault him here as he's trying to get away from Adelius Thomas, but Quincy just couldn't quite come up with this one.
If he catches it in stride, he may very well score. In Jacksonville, Florida, still enjoying today, 24-7 over the Bulldogs in the third quarter. Ryan Pflugner trying to perhaps put this one out of reach. 2:03 to play in the game. A 22-yard field goal try for Ryan Pflugner to make it a 10-point lead for the Tigers. See if it's simply running into the kicker or roughing the kicker, and then you've got a big decision to make if you're Mike Dubose.
Well, you do. The old saying is you never take points off the board, and that's the old saying that Mike Dubose is going
to
go with.
Running into the kicker by the defense, penalty refused, field goal is good.
So he will keep the points on the board, and now Alabama leads it 30-10. Would not have been a first down simply running into the kicker. So really a no-brainer,
right,
for Mike Dubose. Take the points, and you've got less than 2 minutes to play.
A lot of times coaches have tough decisions. As head coaches, that one was not too difficult. You don't care who wins. This has been a great game to watch. It's been agonizing at times if you are partisan to one side or the other, but maybe the best offensive performance by Alabama all year.
Brandon Francis back deep. An impressive scoring drive for Bama, doing exactly what they wanted to, eating up a lot of clock and coming away with some points. Wisniewski, the line drive kick that bounds into and out of the end zone. 12 plays, 82 yards, 5.5 minutes off the clock, and Ryan Pflugner ended it with a 22-yard field goal to give Bama the 10-point cushion with under 2 minutes to play.
A little challenge, too, from Freddie Millins as he went to the sideline talking to his teammates, especially those in the secondary. Say, go ahead, let's put this one away. Bama's going with the nickel package. Obviously, Southern Miss in a passing situation.
Roberts will work from the shotgun. Again, 1:58 to play. The Golden Eagles with only one timeout remaining. Roberts with time. Underneath to Brandon Francis. Brought down by Miguel Merritt. And the clock continues to run after a pickup of only a couple.
Alabama going with only two linebackers right now. I believe it's Horn and Merritt, two linebackers, as we said, going with five DBs.
Golden Eagles in the hurry up on this. And Blacks come in, they'll blow it dead as Southern Miss got off to an early start.
Before the snap, false start on the offense, 5-yard penalty, still second down.
Only the third penalty this afternoon for Southern Miss. A fairly cleanly played game on the part of both teams. Not a whole lot of flags all day long. Clock running at 1:20 to go in the game. Gideon has it go in and out of his hands. Fernando Bryant on the coverage. Reggie Miles also in the neighborhood. That one tipped into the air, and had there been a Bama defender underneath it, the game would have been over because it was clear sailing to the end zone.
Fernando playing that play intelligently, though. Make sure you got the receiver. Don't anticipate the tip. Keep him in front of you.
Oh, God.
minute nine to play, third and 13 for the Golden Eagles. Roberts completes it to Orlando Dantzler. Brought down by Miguel Merritt. Up near the 23, the 24-yard line, so it'll bring up fourth down as the clock continues to run. Good, solid tackle by Merritt, and on fourth and six, the Golden Eagles have no choice but to go for it. Roberts to the boundary and incomplete. Antoine Hunter able to get a hand in there and knock it away, and that should just about do it.
I don't know that he knew the football was coming, but still, good job by Antoine Hunter. Had his man covered. And at the last minute, the ball hits Hunter right in the shoulder.
So with 37 seconds to go, Bama will have to snap it perhaps only one time. What a great day for Andrew Zow. 361 yards. That's the sixth best passing day in Alabama school history. He won't be working on those numbers anymore. He'll take a knee. And if Southern Miss chooses not to call a timeout, that may very well be the last play of the game, but they do decide to call a timeout. 29 seconds to go in the game, and that is the final timeout available to the Golden Eagles.
I hope people appreciate how good a win this is for Alabama, David. Unfortunately, people still have a tendency sometimes to look at Southern Miss as the worst team Alabama has beaten for years. They should be Southern Miss. But Alabama came into this game as the underdog, played awfully solid in all areas except maybe the special teams, and still had some good plays in special teams. Block kick by Kenny Smith, Brian Fluker with a good day with three field goals. A couple of trick plays on the part of special teams by Southern Miss, but really the only knock you can make against the Tide special teams unit. This is a good win against a solid football team that had won three straight coming into today.
We talked about the tough schedule for the Golden Eagles. They opened at Penn State, then came home to play Texas A&M. They started 0-2. They beat Southwestern Louisiana before losing at Tulane, which has turned out to be one of the surprise stories of this 1998 season. Tommy Bowden doing a great job down there, but Bama is going to come away 30-20 winners this afternoon against Southern Miss, and will finish 3-1 this season in Tuscaloosa after going 0-4 here a year ago.
They open it up with a good win against Brigham Young, a solid team, and they'll wrap up the Tuscaloosa portion of their home schedule in similar fashion.
Mike Dubose and Jeff Bauer meet at midfield. It's a pretty good Southern Miss team that Alabama beat today. As you said, a three-point underdog was the Tide coming in. But Bama comes away 30-20 winner.
We don't give a player the game, but if we did, no question, Andrew Zow, the man, put the game on his back offensively and led the Tide to a very good win today.
Next up for Bama, on the road next Saturday against LSU. For Chris Stewart and our entire crew, I'm David Crane. Thanks for being with us. Again, the final Bama winner, 20, 30-20. So long from Tuscaloosa.